Hello everybody, I am Indu Singh. Welcome to Science Zone. We are doing first chapter of chemistry. In my previous videos, part 3 and part 4, we have already done 4 types of reactions: combination, decomposition, displacement and double displacement reactions. Now in this video today, we will study redox reactions. Before starting, I just wanted to inform you that we are strictly following our NCERT syllabus. All the examples and activities explained in my videos are following NCERT. So let's start with the topic, redox reactions. It is the fifth type of chemical reaction. These reactions, word redox, it has been derived from two words. It is a combination of two words, that is reduction and oxidation. Redox word means reduction and oxidation reactions, both are going on simultaneously. Oxidation means when there is gain of oxygen to any substance, chemical substance, or there is loss of hydrogen from any substance, that is called oxidation. If any substance is gaining oxygen, that is oxidation. If any substance is losing hydrogen, that is also called oxidation. Second type, reduction. In case of reduction, there will be gain of hydrogen by any chemical substance, or there will be loss of oxygen. We can see oxidation and reduction are opposite with reference to the gain or loss of oxygen and hydrogen. Here we'll see one example, that is activity
1.11
of NCERT. According to this activity, when brown metal, copper, is heated in the presence of air in a china dish, that brown copper changes to black copper to oxide. It is copper, brown metal, when heated in the presence of oxygen in a china dish, it will form copper to oxide. And color of this compound is black. Now we have to see, in terms of redox reactions, we have to see what is actually happening in it. Copper is gaining oxygen. It is reacting with oxygen. That means copper is gaining oxygen and forming copper 2 oxide. So we can put arrow, copper to copper 2 oxide. Now in this case, what is happening there? There is gain of oxygen by copper, and this process is called oxidation. It is the first part of the activity. When brown copper is heated in a china dish, copper oxide is formed. It is a gain of oxygen and it is a an oxidation reaction. Now if we continue with the activity, second step of activity is, if hydrogen gas is passed over copper 2 oxide, hydrogen gas, second step of the same activity is, we take copper 2 oxide, we know that is a black compound, and we pass hydrogen gas over it, it will form brown copper again, brown copper plus water is formed. Now we have to find out oxidation and reduction in this reaction, which substance is oxidized and which one is reduced. So here we'll see that copper oxide and copper, that means there is loss of oxygen from copper oxide forming copper. So we can put arrow in this direction. That means copper, say there is loss of oxygen. And what is the loss of oxygen called? It is called reduction. So which substances reduced copper oxide is reduced? Now hydrogen, it is forming water. So on the other hand, we will see that there is gain of oxygen to hydrogen. There is gain of oxygen to hydrogen, and it is called oxidation. So reduction is loss of oxygen from copper oxide to copper. Oxidation is gain of oxygen by hydrogen to form water. So in this reaction, oxidation reduction both are going on simultaneously, and this reaction is called redox reaction. Now we have to find out five things out of it. Before starting it, we'll see oxidizing agent. Oxidizing agent, a chemical substance which is reduced during chemical reaction is called oxidizing agent. So which substance is reduced here? Copper oxide is reduced, so it will be oxidizing agent. So copper is oxidizing agent. Now reducing agent, a chemical substance which helps to oxidize the other substance is called reducing agent. So what is reduced, what is oxidized here? Hydrogen is oxidized, so hydrogen is a reducing agent. Now what is the substance oxidized? Substance oxidized is hydrogen, and substance reduced is copper oxide. Substance reduced is oxidizing agent. Substance oxidized is reducing agent. So you can check one thing, that we are getting all the answers from left hand side. When you have to write about these four things, you need not see that side. You will directly see on the left hand side. Substance oxidized, hydrogen is gaining oxygen. Substance reduced, copper oxide is losing oxygen. Oxidizing agent is copper oxide, and reducing agent will be hydrogen. So hydrogen is oxidized to water, copper oxide is reduced. Hydrogen is oxidized to water, and copper oxide is reduced to copper. This is how we have to find out four things into it. Now we'll see another example. ZnO, zinc oxide, reacts with coke, that is carbon, and forms zinc plus carbon monoxide. Zinc oxide reacts with carbon, it forms zinc and copper monoxide. Now we'll see oxidation first. Carbon is gaining oxygen here. There is gain of oxygen. So gain of oxygen is called oxidation. So what is the substance oxidized in this reaction? Substance oxidized is carbon, oxidized to carbon monoxide. Now second thing, reduction. Zinc oxide is at the loss of oxygen, and loss of oxygen is called reduction. That means the substance reduced is zinc oxide, and it is reduced to zinc. Now what is the oxidizing agent? Oxidizing agent is zinc oxide, and reducing agent is carbon. This is how we have to work out these four things in each redox reaction. Another example. Lead oxide reacts with carbon and forms lead plus carbon dioxide. We need to balance this equation to here. It is also similar example like this above equation. Carbon is at the gain of oxygen and forming carbon dioxide. So gain of oxygen is oxidation. Lead oxide, it is at the loss of oxygen. So loss of oxygen is called reduction. Now in your notebook you list out four things. Out of it, substance oxidized, that is carbon to carbon dioxide, substance reduced, lead oxide to lead, oxidizing agent is lead oxide and reducing agent is carbon. Practice more such equations from your NCERT. And in next video, we will continue with the balancing of chemical equations. Thank you.